my experience with debate being a hostile environment has definitely been there, and it hasn't just been on the behalf of the debaters involved, it's been on behalf of the judges involved, right? So I've had, you know, judges not flow, not write anything. You know, flowing is a form of note taking, a form of keeping track of what's going on, and being able to give a very well-rounded, robust, fruitful interrogation of the debate and adjudication of the debate when it's over. And I've had people just put the pen down. I'm just gonna look at you, and it's not out of appreciation. It's not because they're really enjoying what's going on. It's because they're literally not interested and have no intention on validating what you said, your experience, or what you come to know about the space that you occupy, like, at all. And so, I mean, it's a humbling position, right? Because you come in knowing that you're right. You come in knowing that you have something to say, and it makes you wanna work harder to get it together and fine tune it to where they have to listen to you. But that role it can be discouraging, right? And so you have a judge in the back who doesn't wanna listen to you and really doesn't want to be there, be a part of your experience, and be a part of really investigating what's happening in the debate space. I mean, you have a team who has intentionally, you know, come up with arguments against everything that you're doing. So it seems like you're debating three people instead of two sometimes, which can be hard to swallow. But I learned and grew to live for those moments. I learned and grew to understand the debate is a two-hour period, a two-and-a-half-hour period. So I got 2 hours to put on. Every speech is my speech. Your speech is my speech. I'm making you say stuff. You know what I'm saying? And so it really, the attitude and the maturity of it changes after you've been in a while, and you come to understand the hostility to represent the fact that you're doing something right, that you own to something. If they don't want to listen to you, if they're shutting you out, keep it going. And I mean, that's just kind of been my attitude full circle, especially looking back at it. Even the debates I lost, I was happy and okay with, because I said, okay, I might have lost it, but for the last 2.5 hours, I forced you to think about and look at and interrogate and investigate something that you would not have had to think about otherwise. So I'm good with that. I made you pull your brains out. I've seen, just bullet sweating. One team we can never beat, myself and Ryan can never beat, was Northwestern BK. And the best feeling in the world, even though we lost the last debate that we had, was to sit there and wait for an hour for the decision, wait for an hour on pins and needles. And yeah, I'm nervous. Me and Ron a little shook. We put on, we did what we could. But then to look over on the other side of the room and see them hurting, didn't know what to think, about to cry. Hey, cool. We good. We good. I can make it just as hostile as you do. I'm going to just do it in a different way. I'm going to make you uncomfortable, take you off your game. And we'll just see how people fare out in the end.
Wow.